Ladies and gentlemen, tonight we are going to dig into Helm 3. This is just an up and running with Helm 3, so I'll just show you how to install Helm 3 and we'll talk about what it actually is. If you already know what it is, then this video is not for you. But let us get right into it. So, if you use Kubernetes, if you're deploying your application inside the Kubernetes, then you're used to having some K8 files, as some Kubernetes files, like maybe you have some config maps, you have, maybe you can have a config map like this where you are defining a file, but you want to make it more dynamic. Maybe you have a development environment, you have a test environment, you could also have a production environment, and then you want to have different values throughout your config maps, but also through maybe your environment variables, and you want your services to behave differently. You want your default number of pods to be higher when it's a production environment than when it's a development environment. And that is where Helm 3 is so awesome, because it actually supports something called templating. And this actually means that if we have a piece of data in our Kubernetes file, piece of data right here, a key, so this could be our key, then the value, instead of typing in the value, then we can write something like values dot, and then we can make up a value for ourselves, like important, and then my value or whatever I want right here. We will not see this in action in this video tonight, but I'll show you how to install Helm instead, and we will talk a bit more about what Helm 3 actually is. So it is a templating language for Kubernetes. So that is important to understand. That means that we can add templating to the YAML files that we already have, and then we can. They're especially strong if you're using it for CI/CD, continuous integration, continuous delivery. Then you would have a lot of different environments where you would like to deploy the same set of the same artifacts, the same Kubernetes artifacts. You would like to deploy those, but with different arguments and maybe with some minor tweaking and adjustment. And then Helm 3 is just awesome. If you are using Helm 2, do not stop using that right away. Upgrade to Helm 3. Take the time to upgrade your script, because with Helm 2, Helm 2 is not secure, because you have to install something at Tiller. Something called a Tiller agent on the server itself, and that Tiller agent actually has all of the, it has rights to do whatever, everything. So it is not safe to use Helm 2 and Tiller. It is safer to use Helm 3 instead. So I definitely recommend you to use Helm 3. If you use Helm 2, then you also need an annoying plugin. So you would save yourself some hassle if you use Helm 3. And this is since this is latest and greatest, this is also the one. If you need some support online on Stack Overflow, etc., this is where this is the version that has the most the most support. The current version right now is 3.7. But first of all, let us see what can we use this Helm for? Which features does it contain? It has actually a repository. That means that when you make something called Helm charts consists of your Kubernetes files. It consists of the values files. A value file is something you would define, for instance, per environment. You could create a development value file, and then that those values will then be applied whenever you are dealing with your development environment. And then you would also have a production value file, and those values would be applied when you are using your when you're deploying to your production environment. So it is quite smart, but that is called a Helm chart. All of that is called a Helm chart, and it's bundled nicely together inside this folder. Those Helm charts can be distributed to a repository where other people can also, other people can also use your brilliant Helm charts that you are creating. That is the purpose of that. But I would actually recommend that you to actually just place your to not rely on other Helm charts to begin with. To begin with, just place all of your Helm files inside your project and maybe inside a Helm folder, because that is the most that is the easiest if you have any problems and if you need to debug, it is much more easy than it's easier if you have all of the files locally, of course. Then when you feel a bit more comfortable with Helm, then you can start using other people's Helm charts, and you can also start uploading your own Helm charts to maybe your own Helm chart repository. There are also some common repositories you can use out there. More about that in other videos. First of all, how do we install Helm so we can start using it? There are different ways to install it. If you are using Mac, then you can use Homebrew. If you're using Windows, you can use Chocolaty. You can use Scoop, you can use GoFish, you can use Snap. I actually prefer to download it manually. So let us go to the installation right here. Then you can download the desired version, and this is exactly how I installed Helm 3. And there's a lot of possibilities. There's also a script you can download. I'm using WSL, Windows Subsystem for Linux, inside Windows. That means that I'm actually running Linux Ubuntu. So I am going to download my Helm 3 right here. So I'm going to press on desired version. And then we see a lot right here. We see that 3.7.0 is the latest version right here. That is pretty cool. If I want to look for other versions, then I can press the tags. Then I can look at the tags right here. So you can actually see this is just a GitHub project, it is a GitHub project. And here I can actually see all the tags. And I'm interested in version 3.7.0 because I know that it's the latest and stable. If I did not know that, I could just go to the common webpage. I can also see it right here that actually that there's no RC afterwards. That means it's not a release candidate. It is a real version. So then we go here. And then here we can actually see here we got the binaries. And then I would choose Linux AMD 64 like this. I would right click. Then I would copy the link address like that. Then I would open up my terminal right here. And actually, I've actually already cheated. So I actually already have the file right here. But I'll just delete it just for fun. So now I'm deleting my Helm file. I made a new folder in my Home folder. Then I have a folder named Apps inside that Apps folder, and then I have a folder named Helm in here. Getting the file with wget. You can also use curl, of course. Then I'm downloading the file, and it's only 26 megabytes, so it's actually not that much. Then you need to unpack it. I'm going to remove the Linux folder because that is actually what is going to be created. So I'm going to delete this folder right there. So now we don't have any, now there's no folder. So then we're at -xvf. So we are extracting all of the files and into a folder. And then we mention the tarball like that. And now I have my Linux folder right here. Already now, if I want to check the Helm version, then I can just go and find the Helm binary, which is right there. And I can write version, so like this. And then I know, okay, this is the binary for version 3.7.0. Then the next thing you probably want to do is you want to create a symbolic link inside your user local bin folder. So then you write -ln -s. That means you want to create a symbolic link. And then you would just write that folder that we just saw just before. That means home and mic and apps and Helm 3 like this. Helm, and then Linux, and then Helm like this. That is the location of the Helm executable. And then you would write something like user bin local, like this. And also just put into user bin, and then just mention it Helm 3. I've already done that, so I will not press enter on this one right here, because I already have that symbolic link right there. So I'll just list it so you can see it. It's actually right there, and it points to to my executable, which is under my apps folder. So that means that I can actually just write Helm and then version like this. And that is how easy it is to install Helm 3 on your computer. And that's actually it. That's what I want to show you tonight. In other videos, then I wanted to show you how to actually use it, how to create your own chart. Because that is actually the interesting part, but I'm trying to keep these videos short. So I will go right back and say, thank you very much for watching. Have a great evening. Hope to see you again soon. Bye-bye.